Good afternoon, YouTube. We've got a bit of a different project today. Got a couple of these bronze ingots. They weigh about 20 pounds, maybe 9 kilograms, something like that. I don't know if these are silicon bronze or aluminum bronze. Anyway, a neighbor does some metal casting in his garage, and he's picked up a bunch of these ingots. The problem is his crucible is only big enough to hold roughly half of one of these. He had been cutting these in half on an abrasive chop saw, but it takes a long time, and then you waste a lot of material because you've got that thick abrasive blade. With the chop saw, you've got to sit there for 10 minutes trying to saw through this stuff, and it's supposedly fairly hard to cut. I did take a test cut here on my little bandsaw. A bimetal blade does cut it okay. So I did some reading on some home metalworking and home casting forums, and people were talking about cutting these, and they recommended a bimetal blade is one thing. This coarse tooth blade as you can get, as slow a speed as you can get, and as heavy a down pressure as you can get, and lots of cooling and lubrication, because this stuff apparently is fairly hard to cut. That's my regular bimetal blade that I use for most metal. It's a 10-14 variable tooth blade. The coarsest one I could find that fits my saw is this bad boy. I found this one on McMaster Car. It's the coarsest bimetal blade they have, 4 to 6 tooth per inch, so anti-vibration. Anyway, I gotta put this in the saw, and then I've gotta slow the saw speed down. I'm running my 7x12 bandsaw on the highest speed. I haven't run it on the low speed before, so I'll show you how you change the speed on one of these. Okay, we've got the blade in the saw, and now what I've got to do is slow it down. So I've been running, I think, 255 feet per minute, or 78 meters per minute. So what I need to do is bump it up to the small motor pulley and then the large drive pulley. Yeah, so to loosen up the pulleys, there's two nuts right down there. You can see one right there at the light, and then there's one on the other side of the motor. And then over here is a sort of a jack screw. There's a jam nut there, and you loosen the jam nut, wind the bolt out, and then you can tap this slide in, and then that loosens up the tension on the pulley. So let's see if we can get over here. I might need to loosen it up a bit more. Let's see. Yeah, there we go. I was on the Home Machinists forum, and one guy was recommending something as close to 80 feet per minute for machining this, assuming it's the red bronze. I can go down to 90, so I guess I will go as slow as I can here. Get up there. Up there. Yeah, I didn't think I've ever run this saw this slow. So there we go. That's the low speed right there. So this should be 90 feet per minute or 27 meters per minute. So then you just have to tension the belt back up. Okay, I think it's time to give this a try. This blade is really slow. So we've got the coolant running. So let's see what happens here. Whoa! I'm gonna have to put the ingot with the fat side up, I guess. It doesn't quite hold down there. Okay, so I think holding this thing is the hardest part. So what I did was I took a small scrap of aluminum that I had left over, had to cut a little bit off of there, and then I just machined down enough so it was just the height of the ingot laid over on its side. The thing isn't quite square, so you can't get enough gripping force on there to hold it. So I think that's in there pretty good. It's not going to twist. Lower this by hand and we'll see what happens here. There we go. Looks like it's cutting pretty good though. A big hunk of metal there. Whew. Boy, that's a nice cut. Yeah, that's the way to do it, huh? Like nice and cool. Yeah, these ingots aren't square or straight or parallel or anything, but yeah, there we go. Took about 4 minutes. Little piece of metal, so I just cut it off and then machined it down until it was just the height of the ingot. That way I can back up the far side of the jaw, because like I say, those parts really aren't square, or they're very irregular. So yeah, there's one. I think it's about the same height. Yeah, I just got to slide this in and then got to find my halfway mark there. Okay, got that one in. The ingot's a little bit different size, so my center mark was off, but let's give this one a try. Release the down feed. Oh, yep. There's another 10 pounds. Like ripples from the casting, I guess. So I had to go through a few forum threads and different forums and finally found somebody that seemed to have a good idea of what they were talking about. They gave specifics on the blade, the coolant, the down feed, the cutting speed. But yeah, that seems to be a pretty good setup for that. Run it really slow, really hard down feed, lots of coolant, and then you got to get it clamped in there because there's a lot of force on that part. Anyway, I got to get a hold of my neighbor and tell him I finally cut his parts. He's left him here for a couple of weeks and haven't had time to tear the saw apart and reconfigure it. So I figured might as well do that now and give it a test. And yeah, it seems to cut really nice. It doesn't bind up the saw blade. I know when I cut aluminum, one of the problems with aluminum is it'll gum up in the teeth and then jam the saw blade and trip the circuit breaker. So then you've got to unjam the blade, clean it out, wait for the circuit breaker to cool down, then you can reset it. And it takes a lot of babysitting. This cut takes like 4 minutes, so I can just start it, go do something for 3 minutes, come back and catch the piece when it falls off. No babysitting involved, because I think he says he has like 8 or 10 of these ingots that he picked up. So since I can cut them, I might tell him to bring over the other ones and we'll cut them while I have the saw set up. Okay, YouTube. Neighbor brought over the rest of his ingots. He had, I think, 10, 20 pound ingots there. Yeah, I mentioned it was silicon bronze. Anyway, he had 10 of them plus the two I cut before, so that's 12, 240 pounds of bronze. I always find it interesting to think back, you know, 4,000 or 5,000, 6,000 years ago, Bronze Age. That was the go-to metal that you used for your pots and pans and cooking and weapons, axes, swords, knives. Everything was bronze. You know, a piece of steel like that was incredibly expensive. I mean, iron wasn't even a thing, and then you had Iron Age, and then at that point your steel was, you know, a high price commodity. And then even 200 years ago,
piece of aluminum like that was a precious metal. You know, they put aluminum on the cap of the Washington Monument because it was a precious metal. And now you buy aluminum foil and beverages in aluminum cans and just toss them out, or, you know, put them out for recycling. Or this used to be your everyday go-to metal. Collected all the cuttings. There's a little bit of steel and aluminum in there, but yeah, there's a good half pound of shavings in there from cutting all that. One thing I did notice was after cutting 12 of these, the first few I did took 4 or 5 minutes per cut. The last ones were taking way longer, maybe 15 or 20 minutes. You can see here's the earlier cuts. You got pretty coarse marks there, and they're a lot finer on this side, so it was just cutting a lot slower. That blade probably would be getting pretty dull after that many more. So yeah, to cut bronze like that, you probably need a new blade. That was a bimetal blade, 4 to 6 tooth per inch, variable pitch. And yeah, 12 cuts, and it's definitely slowing down. So hopefully it'll still work for aluminum and plastic that I cut, because that was like a $50+ blade, and it made 12 cuts, and it's already slowing down a bit. He showed me his website. He does a lot of this work for galleries, but he has a really nice website. So I'll show you some of that at the end of the video here. Just take a look at some of his pieces.